afternoon, Mr. Piri.
Good afternoon to you today.
Thank you so much for having us this afternoon. We are here, we realize that Khato is constructing, is busy with construction.
Yeah.
Maybe from your point of view, what's going on this afternoon in this office space of yours?
This is Saturday, the 26th of June. Our works on the Masama-Mmamashia pipeline have subsided. We are just doing the testing, so we have started to build this Khato Botswana headquarters. We're starting with the workshop. Already dug 1.3 meters deep for the workshop. This is the workshop, and that is the warehouse, the head office, right in front where the plants are. Now the plants will move to the west, so all that bush will go. We're starting to do that. I mean, you said last time that many companies come here and take money, and
yes,
they don't do anything for Botswana. I said to you, that's why I'm building.
Mm.
We've designed these buildings long time ago, and we intend to put up that. So I've started that in 2 months. You'll have the warehouse here, where the equipment are. We'll have a workshop right here. And then in 3 months, we start building the headquarters. And all these caravans, which have been our offices, are now being built.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So basically what it means is that the first stages, like you're saying, it's not the office space, but it's for the equipment.
This is the workshop is all on our materials.
Mm-hmm.
When we are on a project and all of that, and most of the important things are kept in this workshop. That's why you can see it's massive. The workshop, every machine that is here will now be serviced, maintained in this workshop. Others will be kept behind there. But the headquarters is here, so all the managers will have their offices up here, down there, next to the A1, and we have the whole thing here. It's exciting.
How big is this this place?
It's 4.5 hectares.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Should we expect something bigger than what you already built in South Africa?
Oh yes. We have more space here. In Johannesburg, it's about 4 hectares, but we have pylons passing through our offices, our plot. It's limited how we spread the offices, but still we built the most magnificent building in Johannesburg. So we are well organized. As you know, I am a man of class. I'm not just a person who wants to work, do business in a small shop. No, we're going to have this. You see the standards that we're going to put in here. So the standards will be the same. It's generic, it's more colon. So you take what we have and replicate it everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
In terms of the structure that's already existing there,
yeah,
what then will happen to those structures?
Those now become offices we use when we are on site on projects. So it is one of the assets we are going to keep. Exactly like you can see those equipment there, it will just become part of that, but it will not be on caravans anymore. So it will be a proper establishment. It's going to be an address, of course.
Let's talk about the employees that are going to be stationed here.
Yes.
Or the current, let's start with the first one that are currently working here.
Yeah.
Are these the same guys who worked in the last, in the...
Oh, yes. You see, look at the dozer. You see, that's a dozer. It's a V, I mean, it's a 6-ton dozer.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I used the dozer here. We didn't use an excavator. Because an excavator would have taken 2 weeks to dig 1.3 meters deep. That thing started yesterday, we finished here today on the warehouse, is done. So the geotech engineer will be here on Monday, do the tests. Once they are happy with the levels and the strength of the material on the ground, we start the foundation.
Mm-hmm.
And then from there, we put the beams, it's the roof, and then the big web on the side, ablation, electrification and lights, you know, plumbing, because there will be offices also in these buildings. And it's done in 2 months, and we start the building of the head office here, right in front, immediately.
Yes.
So that's my investment. I can't take money. The money that must go to Johannesburg will go to Johannesburg.
Yes.
The profit and other things stay to Johannesburg.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes. So I'm not a runaway.
the office spaces and the people that are going to be employed here? Are you going to be taking the ones that are currently in here, or are you going to employ new people to fill up positions?
Look, others, the ones who are in to stay in, those who are hardworking, those who are honest, those who are of high integrity, because that's what we want to have. The workforce that is trusted, that is sure to do things that we are asked by clients to do. So those will stay. But obviously, you have to bring in new people from the country. So a lot of Botswana who will be applying, want to be employed, we are here. I am completely for Botswana, that's
yes.
for sure. I don't even, this is not there. People mustn't misunderstand me. I'm completely, but where we are short of skills, we'll bring in people, but you must understand people won't come in permanently. They come for a short period to impart the knowledge, the experience, the expertise, and then they go back to other areas. And even Botswana will get better knowledge here. When we are in the Congo, we'll go there with them. When we are in South Sudan, we'll go there with them. When we are in Malawi, we'll go away with them. As long as there are people who know what they are doing, sure, man, why would I waste time? I'll take them on. I'll bring them in and go with them. So in business, you take your best people and take them where you need them.
Yes.
Yes.
There's someone saying, should I apply for my job already?
Well, apply, and we are reorganizing our human resource department.
Yes.
This time, we'll never put our eyes off the ball. It's not going to be allowed. What happened will not be allowed anymore. And we want people, Botswana, who really can do the job well and are well-trained, they have honesty, they are trustworthy. Those must come. We want them.
In terms of supplies of material and equipment, are we going to be getting some from Botswana, or are you also going to be getting from South Africa? Is it going to be a mixture?
You understand that we are starting a factory in Pigwe for pipe manufacturing. And we hope that our first client is the Malawi Water, Lilongwe Salima Water System from Lake Malawi to Lilongwe.
Yes.
And so that will be the first client. If we get other jobs on pipes and all that, we'll manufacture here. There are materials like tool making. We'll be able to do the flanges ourselves. Be able to project, make the nuts and bolts. These things, we are buying them in Johannesburg and in Richards Bay and Durban and other industrial areas of Johannesburg. But this time we'll be able to do them ourselves. We are capable of doing all of that. Yes.
And then a quick one on the pipeline when we talked about it. At what stage are we at? I understand there are a few leaks that are coming out. Please explain what that really basically means in terms of the testing.
Thank you. What happens actually is that you can't test at high pressure when the pipe is not complete. So once the pipe is complete, you put at 1 bar pressure to pump the water all the way from the source to where it's required. So when the pipe is complete, you pump. Obviously, you will find a leak here, and then you stop the pumping. You attend to that leak. You pump again, but you must pump at high pressure, because that is the final quality control on a pipe construction site. So that is normal to have leaks. Some leaks will be bigger, others will be smaller, but we are up for the task. We are here to correct that. By the time the water reaches Mmamashia in a week, that will mean that the pipe is proper. If it delays by 2 days or 3 days, but by the time it arrives, there will be no leak, nowhere. But that's normal. I mean, people shouldn't hide this issue. This is what all construction, I've never been on a pipe in Johannesburg, Cape Town or Devon, where we have done a lot of pipe laying, where you finish without a pipe laying.
What's the importance of testing for someone who doesn't understand the importance of it? What does it really mean in terms of testing the pipeline with the high pressure?
You should check that the connection, the pipe connection from pipe to pipe, are strong enough to withstand, and that there will be no loss of water, and that there will be no leak. So you test that. Once testing means that you are checking that indeed your construction or your connections of the pipe were done properly. We are humans. Sometimes we have factory regions. Go to Stuttgart. You'll see a lot of Mercedes-Benz cars that are thrown away or they are parked because they don't meet the standards. So that's what we are doing here. Where a pipe didn't meet the other one, we go in, cut it, and we weld to make sure that it reaches the standard that work is expecting of cut. So that's what it is. I mean, defects are there. That's why we have people or animals that are born with defects. You know what I mean? Defects are there, and we sort that out. In this pipeline, the defects we found, we correct them.
So what's your overall impression, though, of the pipeline right now? Are you happy?
Oh, I'm happy. The water is flowing. And where there's a leak, we stop, we correct. The water is flowing. See, look, it's the happiest moment in our life in Botswana. Mm. Because then people have the water. The pipe construction is done. It's finished.
Yes.
What we are doing is pumping, making sure that we don't hand over a pipe that has defects. Yeah.
There's a question here that says, where exactly are your offices?
It's on the A1 past the first engine garage. That engine garage. After the engine garage, you see we are on the left hand side. Yes.
And then in terms of the work, the construction work, how long do you expect it to take?
Which one? This one?
This particular one.
Okay. No, this one will be 2 months. In 2 months' time, the workshop will be done, the warehouse will be done. You can see the equipment. We have there the six-ton dozer. It's dark, it's finished. There is the front-end loader. There is the tipper truck. So everything is moving quick. This side the same. Then all of it done. This is how we work. We work with zeal. We work with purpose and get things done quickly. Yes.
Thank you so much for your time. Any last comments or any last words?
Well, Botswana, we're told a lot of stories about me that, well, I'll make money and run. I'm going nowhere. As you asked me the last time, I'm sure most people have asked you that same question.
Yes.
I'm not a person who ran away from Botswana. As I said, my mother comes from this country. I make money, I will invest in here. This is exactly what I'm doing. Yes, madam.
Thank you so much for your time.
All right, thank you so much.